Hi, welcome back. A new Pew poll found that more than 62% of Americans believe their political side is losing more than they're winning on the issues that matter most. Democrats are angry to see President Obama's signature accomplishments rolled back. Republicans are upset with the lack of progress their party has made despite holding majorities in the House and Senate. Here to explain, co-host of Fox and Friends on the Fox News Channel. He is your cup of morning sunshine. Brian Kilmeade is here, also the author of the brand new book, Andrew Jackson and the Miracle of New Orleans. Hit bookshelves yesterday. Welcome back to the showgram, Brian.
It's the first time you've said the title of the book and didn't sing the song.
Man, 1814, took a little trip.
It's very hard.
Colonel Jackson.
You're trying to be professional. You can't. If every time I say what book you ask me how I'm doing on it, I tell you, you sing the song. That was the first time. We'll cut that out of editing.
No,
right?
We won't, sadly.
Okay.
Right. So I thought we were going to be so sick of winning.
Right.
Yet here, everyone feels like they're losing. What happened?
Right. Well, for President Obama, he's got a lot of things rolled back. ISIS, I know that was a great accomplishment that gave birth during the time, the JV team. Obamacare wasn't working. The stimulus package, there was no shovel-ready projects. What you had is a first family that people thought had great charisma in class.
Sure.
But I just don't think he had a lot of those accomplishments. But I'm amazed. This is the first time I've seen a survey where both sides are convinced they're losing. I've never seen that in sports. I've seen it the other way.
Okay, so we know from math and physics that if you have two negatives, that equals a positive. So if both sides feel like they're losing, on some level, isn't that winning?
No.
Okay.
And I'll tell you why. Do you remember Curious George?
Yes.
Remember, it was a series of books, and he always got himself into trouble. In the back of that book was a magnet. And when you put two negatives together, what happens? They repel each other. There was the back of the magnet. So if they gave you two magnets, or if you got two by mistake, that's what we're happening now. We're moving further from each other. And the one unifying force is the differences they feel about President Trump. I was fascinated to see that between, you know, depending on how conservative you are, 93% of conservatives happy with Donald Trump, and only 10% of Democrats are. It's the exact inverse of where we're going.
Yeah.
But in terms of immigration, in terms of taxes, the view of the global economy, there's some diversity on both sides. We are tearing at each other. Not only don't we agree from parties, but within the party, they're disagreeing.
Well, then
so we're coming
maybe
this way
two
and
parties
that way.
Way too limited in this postmodern day and age. I want to ask you about Old Hickory. Andrew Jackson had one of the greatest political nicknames ever.
Right.
Will Donald Trump have as good of a political nickname in the end?
Well, out of all the questions to prepare for, that's the only one I'm not ready for. I believe Donald Trump, all across the country, everyone has a different name for him.
Okay.
Right? And I depend
on. Some not repeatable, perhaps, on a family show like this.
I would say most.
Yeah.
I went to the Hermitage by myself because you were busy, and I saw a stack of binders. I said, what's in there? They say newspapers. Andrew Jackson subscribed to 16 newspapers a month, at which time he would look at all the articles about him, highlight them, and then promote and point out the incorrections. I will say President Trump does the same thing. He looks at articles, and he says the problem he had with the media.
Yeah, and so sometimes he'll send articles about himself highlighted to other people.
The only reason I think you'll love this book is because it's free. I'll give it to you.
Thank you.
Number two is because it's a great American story. It'll outline why we should be prideful of America and how miraculous so many of our victories were and how close we got to total extinction. That's what this book
highlights. Did any of the Tripoli pirates fight in the Battle of New Orleans?
You're trying to link all my books together in a way Seinfeld does in a 28-minute episode of Seinfeld.
Yep.
Comedic callback. Yes.
Very good, Brian Kilmeade. Thank you very much.
Yeah.